Hey everybody, welcome to my channel. Here we are with the Mercury Twelfth readings for all zodiac signs. This is going to be for Pisces, Moon, Sun, and Rising. Regarding your love life for the month of August 2017. If you're interested in any private consultations or any of my services, definitely look at the description box below. You'll be able to find my contact information on there. If you would like to support my channel, definitely check out the Patreon page that I created. This is to give you guys better content and basically give you guys more videos. Okay, so let's see. And again, if you haven't subscribed, subscribe to my channel. So that's what Spirit has for you, Pisces, for the month of August 2017. Regarding your love life. Okay, this is the last shuffle. Let's get into your reading, Pisces. Okay, you have the Page of Swords, the Ten of Wands, the Page of Wands, and the Six of Wands. Partner's cards is the King of Pentacles, the Nine of Swords, the Six of Swords, the Hierophant, and you have the Three of Wands regarding the overall situation. So the Three of Wands as a center issue has to do with waiting. You're basically waiting for something. So you're either waiting on a message or you are waiting for clear communication to come through in regards to your partner, or the person that you're interested in. Okay? You're entering the month of August with the Page of Swords. So be very mindful. Try the best you can to, I wouldn't say bite your tongue, just be careful what you say. You can come out being a little bit rude or a little bit too blunt for your nature. And what I mean by that is Pisces are usually good-hearted people. You guys are usually very compassionate for other people when it comes to communicating. So again, the Page of Swords is you're very cutthroat. You could be very blunt. Almost a little bit passive aggressive. So try the best you can to keep those emotions on check, Pisces. You don't want to come off as being, you know, a little brat, basically. So you have the Ten of Wands. You guys are dealing with a lot of struggles. This could be a representation of, you know, the relationship becoming a little bit, it's becoming a little bit of a weight on you. It could be the fact that you're usually the one to be dealing with all the emotions. Maybe your partner has been a little bit standoffish, and that's the reason why the Three of Wands is here. Or it can also be a representation. You know, threes are third-party energies. So again, it could be you having doubts of your partner, or it could be your partner having doubts. And all this bickering and fighting is definitely having an effect or a toll on you at the present time. You have the Page of Wands here, and again, it's communication. So you may be communicating with a fire sign. A fire sign would be a Leo, Aries, or Sagittarius, and you may be dealing with a new person. The new person would be a Virgo, or that of an Earth sign, so it would be a Capricorn, Taurus, or Virgo. And again, waiting or communicating with this person. I feel that by the end of the month, you're going to feel accomplished, or you're going to feel victorious in regards to the relationship. I feel for some of you guys, I feel like you guys may be dealing with an ex-partner, meaning you guys recently broke up, and this person is reaching out to you because the Three of Wands could be a representation of that. And they may be reaching out to you right at the pivotal moment when you are actually taking steps towards another person, okay? For some, it can also be the fact that you are in a relationship, but you're no longer interested in that partner, the person that you're with, and you're already at the present time stepping away from that relationship and actually making or having conversation and communication with this Virgo or this Earth sign. Okay, so how your partner sees the situation or how they're, you know, viewing the relationship, King of Pentacles is very grounded energy, but with the groundness of that energy, it could be a symbology that they are being a little bit standoffish, they're being a little bit cold towards you. There's not an emotional attachment or connection there. For some of you guys, I mean, for some of you guys, it could be the fact that you guys, for those that are married or in a long-term committed relationship, what it can also represent is just financial stability, and that's the reason why you're there, or that's the reason why they are in that relationship with you. The Nine of Swords is a representation of having a lot of anxieties. So again, the two, the Ten and the Nine of Swords are mirroring one another. So I feel that for you, you're seeing your partner as, you know, a burden at the present time, and your partner is seeing you as you're just not understanding them. They are literally having anxiety or dealing with a lot of sleepless nights. You know, it could be vice versa. It could be the other way around. It is a general reading. But the Nine of Swords is definitely a heavy energy, and it's an energy where they're all in the mind, meaning not sleeping. For those of you that recently broke up or there is a separation, this person is definitely, you know, having a difficult time, but they do have the Six of Swords, and the Six of Swords is moving on or moving away from this relationship. If you guys are currently in a relationship, there's going to have to be a choice made here, as the Six of Swords is followed right after the Hierophant, and the Hierophant, you know, does speak about wisdom and understanding, but it also speaks about making choices, having a choice, having to choose whether to continue on this relationship or completely end it and walk away. For those of you guys that are currently married, maybe you guys have been dealing with a third party type of energy, and again, like I said, it could be that, you know, this person is actually already stepping out, talking to someone else. Again, like I said, it could apply on both spectrums because it is a general reading. But there is definitely a moving on, and there is definitely a feeling of coming out of this situation, being victorious or being able to connect with someone that is more connected or can connect emotionally to you. I know Pisces are very emotional creatures. So it is necessary if you no longer feel that connection. My advice is always keep it 100. Be honest. If you're no longer happy in that relationship, then love yourself enough to walk away from it. And, you know, if it's you, the one that's dealing with third party type of energies, again, love yourself enough to walk away from that. We all deserve respect and loyalty above everything. So just know that. Again, for those of you guys that are married, there might be an agreement or, you know, a breakthrough when it comes to being able to communicate with this Three of Wands. I feel like for some of you guys that are in partnerships and that are a long-term partnership, for some of you guys, ego is involved. It's kind of like, you know, maybe you say or do something that kind of triggers your wife or your husband, and you guys are not very quick to say, I'm sorry. You'd rather them come to you and offer you that apology. Try the best you can not to be ego-driven at the end of the day. Try the best you can to love each other and show each other respect. Ultimately, that's what lasts. Ultimately, that's what maintains relationships, okay? So I hope you guys can balance that. I wish you guys the very best. Like, share, and comment my videos. If you haven't subscribed, subscribe to my channel. And we will see each other soon, okay?